When the craftsman Daedalus was imprisoned in the very labyrinth he had created, his only solace was his son, Icarus. To escape their plight, he fashioned wings of feathers and wax. He warned his son to fly neither too high nor too low, but his son, enraptured by the freedom of flight, flew too close to the sun. Thus the wax in his wings melted, and he fell to his death. What was the sun's error? Was it Daedalus who was careless, giving the wings to Icarus, knowing that all young men are rash? After the death of his son, Daedalus withdrew in sorrow to a foreign land. King Minos came looking for the craftsman to exact his revenge. The answer to a riddle revealed where Daedalus dwelled, but for Minos, that answer was his ruin. Consider King Minos burned in his bath as you seek your own answer.
The megastructure, it's opening.
Three receivers, three towers, three beams, as we suspected. I think this is an invitation.
Doesn't look that inviting to me.
If you consider the size of the entire structure, then that opening must be big enough to drive a building through.
Or the VTOL.
You want us to go in there, into the creepy triangular Maw of Death.
Maw of Death? I think it looks charming. To quote 1K, come on, Al, live a little.
Byron's right. We're here to explore, and this is a mystery worth investigating. This technology could change everything.
Oh, all right. I'm not winning this, am I?
Nope. Let's meet up with the VTOL, everybody. We're going in.
I finished my analysis of the particle clouds. At first I thought they might be some kind of nanotechnology, but I was wrong. It's a lot worse than that. What we're looking at is a completely unknown type and state of matter. Completely inexplicable within our understanding of physics. Created and manipulated by someone.
Fascinating.